Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here with a new Lego system series sort of mock that I've made for my city. This is just an old school motorboat, pleasure boat. It's intended to be something I'd say from roughly the 1950s or thereabouts, maybe even the 40s, rebuilt in the 1970s, re-outfitted in the 1970s. I was going to build something for my police force. I was actually going to get started on my police station that I need to make, since I have all the vehicles done for that. And I went to work on that and just didn't have any inspiration for it, you know, and my heart just wasn't in it at all. So I started looking around and realized that I did want to build a boat. This boat hull is the one that came with the Coast Guard plane set, the 2013 Coast Guard plane set, which I reviewed. And when I got that, I immediately knew, with the reddish brown top and the gray hull, that I wanted to make something a little bit old-timey for the look of it, just to match that. And here we go. It is done. I have created this thing. And I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. It definitely has the look of the type of craft that I was going for, with that mostly open wheelhouse section to it, and the shorter cabin. Really don't have many parts in the tan color, especially things that aren't just regular straight or rectangular bricks. So that was rough getting some of the shapes in there, but I just was able to pull it off. Just had enough parts that would make it work out. So it I'm pretty happy with this, and got some details added in towards the end of it that just added to the old time kind of nature to it, kind of look, with some of the gold colored, or they're intended to represent bronze colored elements, with the marker lights and the mooring points. I forget the proper name for this. I'm sure that somebody will be down in the comment section very quickly on that one. People love to correct folks on YouTube. I've got a little bit of the dark color in there, the dark brown color, a little bit of the dark tan. And then in the front, you've got this sun deck or tanning deck right here with a pillow on it, and there's a gal there who's listening to some tunes and sipping on something like a root beer float with cherries on it. There's no relation between the captain of the boat, pilot of the boat, and her. You can see he uses the sumo wrestler torso, so a big fat belly on him, and he's intended to be just some really over the hill has been dude who's just completely let himself go, but he still thinks that he's really cool. And he's got this old wooden boat, and for some reason hot women like to just get onto his boat and just ride around, and he thinks that he's really cool because of that. He doesn't have a girlfriend, he lives alone, doesn't have a wife, never has. He's actually a pretty lonely guy, but he's happy with himself nonetheless. He's got his boat, and he just goes out in the water, and that's what he does. And from time to time, you'll see different women sitting up there. They don't really talk to him. They just get on, and he goes out into the water, and they come back, and that's that. This actually was built with a little bit of detail beyond what you can just see from the outside. So I'll take this top off here. Got a newspaper there, got a little bit of an instrument panel. I'll take this off. You can see that there is a cabin hatch or door right here that's leading down inside, and there's a little bit of a hint of stairway down there. Back here there's actually a little compartment in there that might be access, probably store some stuff in there. And then underneath the cushions here would be access to the engine. From the top, and you can see you've got a cushion on the back, but then you can also take the top of this off and see I got a little bit of detail inside of it. Let's get under there. There we go. Should be able to pull this off. There we go. So I've got a little place to sit down and eat or drink, and he's got a little television set that's built into the wall there. And it's just kind of, everything's just kind of squished in there because it was really running low on space. Do have a sink over on this side and a little bit of I guess kind of a countertop space. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Originally it was supposed to be a lamp. I don't know if it's a lamp or some sort of food, drink, spice item. It was supposed to be a lamp though. And then there's a bed there up towards the front. So when, I guess the guy might even live on his boat, so that might actually be where he sleeps at night. Regardless, I'm happy with how this thing here turned out. I did look at some various pictures of old boats and old pictures of old boats to get some inspiration for some details. I really didn't follow after any actual boat that's been created, but I was just getting some hints and some pointers and some ideas that allowed me to put together the parts that I had to make something that I was pretty satisfied with, and got a little bit of backstory in there. I'm going to try to have some form of backstory behind a lot of my minifigures in the city. I feel like that just adds a lot of life to the whole thing. You know, just figuring out either starting with some backstory and using that to create the minifigs, or starting with a minifig just randomly, which I'll do frequently. It's just, you know, put stuff together and then come up with a backstory for them. That can be really fun too, just based on the random parts that were chosen. So there you go, just an old timey boat, and this will go in the marina or harbor kind of area on my Lego City, and looking forward to bringing you more stuff. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.